We'll give you an overview about the Lebanese Red Cross. LRC was established in 1945. We have around 12,000 volunteers and less than 400 staff. We have different programs and sector within the Lebanese Red Cross. We have the emergency medical service, disaster management sector, medico-social department, blood banks, and others. Our goal is to promote peace, serve the society, and alleviate human suffering with neutrality and without any kind of discriminations. So we'll give you like an overview about one of very sensitive mission as a Lebanese Red Cross we were called in 2017. We were called one because as a Lebanese Red Cross, we are always work equal with everyone and we are respecting our seven principles. So this mission, it was for removal of fighters to Syria from ISIS and Nusra. We had around 8,000 families, including the fighters. So the mission, it was to transfer them back to Syria, plus the injured. Again, this, it was secret missions. We were not allowed to speak a lot about it. Because of that, now you see a map, but surprise, we will not be showing a lot of information about it. So I will just speak about our mission. We developed around 150 staff and volunteers in this mission. They were equipped with tracking system, and we are using the GIS with the maps. And one of our emergency response plan, it was to put plan A and plan B and plan C, what if? And we were not able to do that without the GIS. Especially this area, it have no infrastructure. It's not poor, there's no infrastructures. Again, we had poor communication in some of the areas. And again, the road, it was really very small. And we call around 200 buses in this mission as well to transfer them. And by using the tracking system in our ambulances and in our volunteers, it's for their safety, to track their missions, and to make sure that they are safe. If we need to speak about the Lebanese war and conflict, since the independence, 1944, Lebanon faced 11 major conflicts, both internally and external. And the internal one after the independence, it was almost for 15 years, between 1975 to 1990. It's not only that, it's followed by continuous war and conflict, and the big one, it was in 2006. Again, this map, it will be showing all the analysis and the data for the damage area, and the big points, it is showing where the bombing is. One of our main vision and objective as a movement is to leave no one behind. And do no harm. And in order to do that, the GIS will help us a lot to take decisions and to plan properly and to look exactly where most of the bomb was happening, looking at the history, especially where there was bombing the main road and the bridges where we are not allowed to respond in a good time. So, this, again, it's one of our main plan to empower and support the community as a first responder using the map to take the right decisions.
Okay, so Syria crisis. I believe that everyone in this room knows about Syria crisis. It has been in the headlines news in the last 8 years. So as a result of this crisis, 1.5 million Syrian refugees moved to Lebanon, seeking for safety and protection. Actually, Lebanon has the highest rate of refugees per capita, according to his population. One over four of the Lebanese population are refugees. So if you can see in this map, the highest number of informal settlement, see? So again, we use GIS to support and to serve these refugees, supporting them with food, medical social assistance, and any other, many other services that Red Cross provide. Emergency medical services. Also, Lebanese Red Cross is the main provider for ambulance services across the country. So with the approximately 280,000 mission per year, we serve for free based on 4,000 volunteers. We cover almost 80% of the total number of missions across the country. And to achieve our goal, we need data. And our goal is to reduce response time. So again, we use a GIS model to run this application on GIS to calculate the approximate time needed by ambulance to reach every village in Lebanon. As a result, we know exactly where to have to open a new ambulance station or a resources collocation, and even train a first responder in the remote area. As well, Lebanese Red Cross is the main provider also for blood services. Every year, we provide more than 140,000 blood services. As well, we use GIS also. If you see this map, we use GIS also because the demand is high, and sometimes we have a shortage in some blood types. So with GIS, we can locate our blood donor based on their type. So we can run blood blood drive to collect more blood. So as a result, our blood donation increased from 20,000 last year, the year before, and to 35,000 in 2018. So to know more about technical details, you can join us tomorrow in our presentation. Thank you. And that's it.